Good evening. We have new details on a story we brought you yesterday about people firing weapons at an abandoned pit in Escambia County.
Neighbors in the area are understandably concerned after finding stray bullets in their homes, cars, even a swimming pool. Hannah Mackenzie got to the bottom of things today and joins us live with more.
So those neighbors tell us that the bullets have been flying at the property off Longleaf Drive for about a year. Now it's rumors that are flying as to who is behind the shootings, and we may have just gotten the answer.
It started as just a few rounds being fired occasionally, but now neighbors say the gunfire is constant and it's become dangerous. Larry Huntley, who lives about a block and a half away from the property, decided it was time to get some answers.
When I drove up here, there were three deputy cars parked on the side of the road and there was one private truck.
Larry snapped these photos and sent them to Escambia County Commissioner Jeff Bergosh.
I sent the pictures to the sheriff's office just so that they knew. At that point, I didn't know if it was them shooting. I thought maybe they were down there investigating. And then today on Facebook, on your page, the owner of the pit confirmed it. He said, no, we've allowed the SWAT team down there. We've allowed deputies, and it's been about a year. So that was a surprise to me.
We reached out to the owner of the land and the Escambia County Sheriff's Office. The landowner didn't get back to us, but the Sheriff's Office did. They published a response on their Facebook page. It reads in part, "The ECSO SWAT team has used the land to train on, but no calls were made about property damage on the dates the ECSO was utilizing the range. It is common for SWAT teams to train in different locations like schools, churches, and other businesses to be prepared for any situation."
You know, it was rumors. Some of the residents suggested that they thought maybe, but now we know for sure.
Now that we know who's behind the shooting, neighbors who have found bullets wedged into the sides of their homes and cars are left wondering, is this legal?
If it's legal, let us know that and then we'll learn to live with it, I suppose. But the concern is whatever's going on is not being contained to the pit.
But the answer isn't clear. Allison Rogers, the county attorney, told us over the phone, with regard to firearms and ammunition, over the last 10 years, for the most part, the state legislature has broadly preempted regulation from local governments. Meaning when it comes to firing guns, it's up to state officials to regulate, not local government. For those who live in the area and are concerned about their safety, the law just doesn't seem to make sense.
It's just hard for me to believe that even in Florida, you can kind of shoot guns kind of anywhere you want to and with bullets flying and hitting houses. It's just hard to believe that we would condone that.
Well, there are some exceptions, though, like when zoning or noise issues come into play. Right now, county staff are reviewing whether zoning regulations can be cited in this particular case. Hannah Mackenzie, Channel 3 News.